Lesson 6, Health and Hygiene. In this lesson, we learn about communicable and non-communicable disease, disease caused by bacteria, virus, protozoans and worms, modes of transmission of disease, ways to prevent communicable disease, some non-communicable disease, ways to keep the surrounding clean. In today's video, we are going to cover the topic communicable disease and disease caused by virus. So here we will start the lesson. What is this, children? This is word image which is given in your book. Here you have to find it out, two lifestyle disease and four deficiency disease. You know, children, what is lifestyle disease? Disease which are caused by the physical activities, by the lack of physical activities, unhealthy eating, alcohol, drugs and smoking. So that are the lifestyle diseases, whereas deficiency disease are caused by the lack of vitamins, minerals and nutrients in our body. So in this word image, scurvy, beriberi, anemia, diabetes and rickets, these are the deficiency disease, whereas obesity and diabetes are the lifestyle disease. Why? Obesity is caused because of increase in weight of our body, whereas diabetes also is caused by the weight increasing, and in diabetes blood pressure is also high. So these two diseases are lifestyle diseases. Okay, these diseases caused because of our lifestyle, whereas this scurvy, beriberi, anemia and all rickets, these are caused by the lack of vitamins, minerals and nutrients in our body. So here the introduction of the chapter, first question comes in our mind, what is health? It is right said that health is wealth, the state of complete physical, mental and social well-being of an individual is called health. If you are mentally, physically, socially well, it means you are fit, you are good in your health. It is very important for everyone to keep fit and fine. Normally, one requires a good diet and exercise. So, if you do exercise every day and your diet is very good, so your health will be also good. However, there is another factor which also contributes to maintaining good health, that is keeping away from disease. So another thing that you should keep away from the disease, yourself. When the normal function of the body is disturbed, the person may be suffering from a disease. If your normal function of the body means you are not behaving like normally, if your organs are not working normally as normal, it means you have some disease. Disease may be caused due to the metabolic malfunctioning of organs or due to deficiency of nutrients. Disease are, if your organs are not working properly or the deficiency of nutrients are there in the body. Deficiency means lack of nutrients are there in the body. It means that you have some disease. Disease can be broadly divided into communicable and non-communicable. Communicable disease are the disease which are caused by germs. They are transmitted from an infected person to a normal person. These germs are transferring from one infected person to the normal person. Communicable disease are also called as infectious disease. Casual organisms like communicable disease are caused by the entry of germs. These disease causing germs are the pathogens. Okay, these are the germs, and these germs when enter in your body, so that is called pathogens. Okay, these disease causing germs, that disease causing germs, the germs which are causing the disease, they are said to be pathogens. These pathogens may be virus, bacteria or protozoa. Disease are also caused by worms and insects. Okay, when insects bite, you know, then also you can get fever and all. So that is also, that's why it is said that diseases are also caused by worms and insects also. By biting your dog also you can be sick, no? So this way we can say that disease is caused by the worms and insects and by the animals also. Disease caused by virus. Now here are the disease which are caused by viruses, such as common cold, rabies, chickenpox, influenza, yellow fever, conjunctivitis, polio, measles, dengue, jaundice, AIDS. Now we are going to study about all these diseases one by one. Common cold. It is a common viral disease. The person suffers from sore throat, running nose, sneezing and cough. What are the symptoms of the cold? You have sore throat, okay? Then running nose, sneezing, coughing, these are the common symptoms of the cold. Influenza. Influenza is commonly known as flu. Other name is flu of influenza and is highly infectious disease. The person suffers from body pain, fever, running nose, cough, fatigue and general discomfort. Measles. In measles that affects children, it affects children. It starts with headache, running nose, sneezing and fever. Small red spots appear on the skin which spread over the whole body. The small red spots appear on the skin and it spreads on the whole body. That is the symptoms of measles. Rabies. The virus that causes rabies attacks the central nervous system. This virus of the rabies, it attacks your central nervous system. The person has difficulty in swallowing food. Symptoms are that you won't be able to swallow food and is afraid of water. Hydrophobia. Hydro means water, phobia means afraid, frightened. Okay, so the people who is suffering from rabies, these are the symptoms that they hardly swallow the food and they are scared of the water. Okay. And for the rabies people, know you should like a dog biting or the cat had bitten you. So this type of disease cause. Now next you have chickenpox. Chickenpox, the symptoms of chickenpox is low fever, red cutis on arms, legs and face and the low fever. It is accompanied by low grade fever. Conjunctivitis. It is a disease of the eye. The person suffers from irritation of the eye. The eye becomes red and there is a watery discharge. There is watery discharge in your eyes. Yellow fever. The disease is prevalent in Africa and its common symptoms include headache. Symptoms of yellow fever: headache, backache and bone pain. Vomiting may also occur in yellow fever. Polio. Polio, the virus that causes polio infects the central nervous system. You have now already studied that rabies also affects the central nervous system. Same way polio also affects your central nervous system. The activities of the skeletal muscles of the limbs are affected. Limbs of the person is affected. The muscles fail to work and wither away. The limbs become paralyzed. It becomes paralyzed. So the person is not able to walk and the person becomes crippled. And here you can see the image that a child is taking polio drop. So to prevent from this disease, these polio drops are given to children. Dengue. The person suffers from high fever with headache and backache. There may be pain on eye movement also. These are the symptoms of dengue and it is caused by biting of mosquito. Jaundice. It is primarily liver disease. Skin, eye and urine show a tinge of yellow color. Tinge of yellow color means slightly yellow in color. And here is the AIDS. You know children, what is the full form of AIDS? Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. AIDS is caused by the human immunodeficiency virus, commonly known as HIV. The immune system of the body fails and the person becomes weak and prone to disease, likely to sick. Okay, so these all are the we have studied the disease caused by the viruses. In our next class, we'll study about diseases caused by bacteria. Thank you, children.